big changes recently made, along with a brand new ranked playlist coming in for the MCC, guys, along with some featured playlists that will be coming in soon for this wonderful game as well. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you some news and information when it comes to Halo. If you like these news informational videos, please make sure to tap that like button, as it lets me know you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what your thoughts are of these changes, because they'd be rather, some people have their own opinions on these. And also, if you want to stay up to date with everything going on in the Halo community, that's news, info, and just commentary topics in general, make sure to tap subscribe, guys. So let's get right into the content here. So, recently on the Halo Waypoint, Postman's put up a new update when it came to the MCC right now, mainly of course focusing on the Halo Reach side of things, as there have been some criticisms when it comes to the game modes that are available for it and the different kind of starts and stuff like that. So they went in and actually made a few changes along with what's going to be coming in the future for playlist changes as well, guys. So let's get right into the info here. So the start out with for the social 4v4 slayers is that they increase the weighting of AR starts compared to DMR starts, as the weighting has changed from a 3-to-1 DMR AR to now a 1-to-3 DMR AR when it comes to starts. So basically 66% of the time you're going to be playing with AR starts. For me personally, I actually like playing with the DMR starts, though I do know that some people have had this sort of criticism when it comes to, you know, only mainly starting out with the DMR. I really remember Halo Reach really having the DMR as like the starting weapon, kind of like a battle rifle in that fact. Though I do understand people's concerns when it comes to just playing with the DMR every single time, as in some maps may play a little bit better or play a little bit worse depending on your starting weapon. So hopefully with this new weighting of AR starts being like 66% of the time you're playing with AR starts in Social Slayer, that will hopefully see people will be more interested in the game. If we're like, man, I really like my DMR starts, but that sucks, like, don't worry, guys, because they have your DMR starts over now in the ranked playlist, that they have a ranked team Slayer for Halo Reach right now. And it actually does have partial team matching, so squads of 3 and up will only match each other. So if you're solo queuing or a party of 2, you'll only match with randoms and parties of 2, where if you're partying up with a team of 3 or 4, you will be only matching against teams of 3 and 4. So keep that in mind. So I might be jumping into this playlist just because of that fact of just that, knowing that I'm not have to worry about the stress of it getting stomped on by parties. Because when you're playing with a duo, that's pretty tough right there. When you're going against 3 or more or in a team in communications, that can be pretty tricky right there. They also have some various weighting on the maps as well. So the highest weighted maps are Powerhouse, Zealot, and Asylum, where the mid-weighted maps are Countdown, Reflection, Unanchored, Battle Canyon, and Forge World Variants, Kingdom, Synapse, Imago, I think it's pronounced it, Select, and Unconquered. And then the lowest weighted maps are Boardwalk, Sword Base, Condemned, Penance, and Illu. I guess you pronounce that one too. I guess you can kind of tell that the people who really don't like some of those lower weighted maps are probably for the best that they do kind of sit down the lower ends, because Boardwalk 4v4 is pretty slow. I remember that back in the day that was a time limit game every single time. Sword Base might be one of the worst maps I think ever in Halo history. Maybe I'm just going to throw that one out there. And obviously Penance, not a whole lot of people are fans of that map either. So, but you know, they kind of have to keep it in the rotation because it's like a vanilla map and, you know, yada, yada, yada. Anyways, so. Also in this post, that Possums goes into talking about how people have been kind of wanting AR starts when it comes to big team battle, as they've been saying that with DMR starts, that it could be rather stagnant and rather unforgiving when it comes to playing BT. Be with the DMR starts. And they, you know, the 343 has recognized this issue. They are a little hesitant to make this kind of change, because obviously that's a big change when it comes to the BTP playlist. And from my experience, at least, well, I remember BTP always starting with the DMR, but I mean, it could be, I think this is more just kind of an issue of when you have a hit scan weapon like the DMR and how you get, how accurate it is over range, that it's it can be pretty tough to break setups and move around the map. Or if you're like in a Warthog, how you can get maybe sniped out pretty easily due to it being a hit scan weapon and also that it's so accurate. They do mention though that they are kind of concerned about the balance changes and how that could affect the gameplay, especially with a lot of people, you know, making such a drastic change like that can make things pretty difficult. Because if you guys do know that, you know, playing with a Magnum, it's starts, it's kind of rough with AR starts, I should say. Like if you have a DMR or even the needle rifle when it comes to TU updates, and everyone else is using like a AR Magnum combo, oh my god, that's, you're like a legend just because of the weapon pickups that you have. And so it's certainly something they're looking to take into consideration, and they're going to be bringing this up in one of the future playlist updates, guys, which they will be going into soon, right later on this video. But right now I want to talk about this new feature that they have coming in called the featured game category. So basically this is some kind of feature that they want to roll out with various game updates, and basically gonna rotate new featured modes in the match composer for you to get a chance to hop in and play on, they say, like, on a weekly cadence. So we'll see how that plays out as well. So it'd be kind of fun to get some new reasons on why you want to hop on and play, you know, some more MCC. They said they focus on new content, so as in probably Halo Reach, but they certainly will be willing to jump over, I'm sure, to play like other modes and stuff like that. Whatever kind of what people want to play the most, I'm sure they'll make a playlist on that. They said the second featured category is what they're going to do is a kind of experimental new settings kind of mode that may or may not like work for core game modes, as in say like an AR BTB start. They said they're actually looking to get that a chance for people to actually play it, get the general consensus from the community, and if that's something that they want, they might implement it into like the basic version of BTB or just other playlists as well. They do mention actually with the, for the first one being the featured category, about having a CE anniversary game type like Power or like Power Slayer or Shoddy Snipes, things like that. So that would be awesome. If you guys never got a chance to play CE Anniversary in Halo Reach, it actually plays out super well. In fact, maybe a little bit better than original CE. Just saying, just throwing that out there. But the CE Anniversary plays is actually a huge amount of fun. They brought back the 3-shot Magnum in that playlist as well. So definitely want to give you guys a heads up on that. When that update does come in, you better believe I'll be making a video telling you guys all about it. So make sure you follow guys on the channel here to keep you guys up to date with everything going on the channel here. So leave it in the comment section down below, guys. I do read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. But, you know, leave a comment what your thoughts are on these changes. Did you like your DMR starts in social? Or are you clamoring for some ranked Team Slayer action right there? I definitely want to give this a go on my next stream for sure, guys. So yeah, and also if you want to stay up to date with everything going on in the Halo community with news, info, and all that good stuff, make sure to tap subscribe, guys, keep yourself up to date. If you're missing any content from me or new to the channel, make sure to check out the videos on the screen right now, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.